poll of 2017 saying, where's the Vol? And then I was promised a lot more of it this year, and it's rolled over again.
You've had it. I mean, you had a lot of Vol.
It was February it.
I think for the time being, for the S&P, yes. But you still have a lot of Vol in global equities. I mean, EM has had a lot of Vol.
Yeah.
Rates have had some Vol. Commodities have had a lot of Vol. So this isn't 2017 where just being long almost wherever where you were, didn't matter. But look, I think the S&P is very close to an all-time high. You got to give a 10-year bull market the benefit of the doubt, or a 9-year bull market the benefit of the doubt. And you know, the fact that the VIX gets down to 10 doesn't mean the market's going to start correcting again. It can stay there for a few weeks or a few months if it wants to.
Andreas, perhaps some realistic optimism from Michael, but is February around a corner? I think that's what a lot of people are going to be asking if we go through that record high on the S&P again.
Look, no crystal ball on this side, but what I would say is that we could point to earnings and say, hey, you know, 24% year-over-year earnings. Even if you look forward 1 year out, we're still looking at 8% year-over-year after we just had 24% year-over-year. So if they keep delivering, if companies keep delivering, it's hard to make the argument against equity. And one thing to keep in mind is in January, multiples were at 18. But because earnings have delivered, they're now at 17, even though we're close to all-time highs. Right, so valuation is a little bit stretched, but nothing.
So one thing they're not mentioning, and I'm bringing this up to the audience because this is one reason why I am very bullish on cryptos, and I do see a stock market collapse coming sooner than later. Obviously, maybe not this year, maybe next year, is the fact they're not talking about stock buybacks. Now, the financials do look good. And it does look like the global economy, the numbers look good. But, you know, there is records amount of stock buybacks, which they're not mentioning. And it is going to be interesting to see if these numbers will continue with the rates going up. But let me know your thoughts on this. I'm obviously not completely out of the stock market, but I am taking advantage of this cryptocurrency dip. And I am selling some of my stocks that are overvalued, and I'm picking up cryptocurrencies that I think are undervalued, which is any crypto in the top 10 right now. But let me know your thoughts on this, and I will talk to you guys soon.